is he gonna back up and turn around and go in and turn around, and what's he gonna do?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
We'll find out.
He's a backing up.
Yeah, he's a truck driver, he don't want to figure it out.
I'm going to take flyers that I'm making up here tonight now to all the surrounding businesses in that area to let them know that I'm going to be there the following day with breakfast and lunch. So, you know, just introduce myself and also in the email I mentioned about the lady that she owns the laundromat across from where I'm vending on the weekends. And she buys from me every day that I'm there, Saturday and Sunday. I've been throwing in like a Thursday or a Tuesday in that area where I'll just pop up and set up. And, you know, it's mostly pretty good. I get people that drive by and stop. It's mostly foot traffic that stops.
Right, right.
You know, now I got flyers inside the laundromat, so, you know, people could come over and, you know, get a hot dog and what. And whenever, I'll even deliver her hot dogs to her because I get to walk through the entire, like, I have to walk inside the laundromat and then across. Basically, I get to talk to most of the people that are in there and, you know, because I'm happy, I'm smiling, I'm, you know, I'm a personable guy, so I, you know, go up to everybody and, you know, tell jokes or whatever and let them know to come over and look for the red umbrella across the street. So it's working, man. It's like a dream come true. I can't believe it. And it hasn't even been a month. I'm crazy excited. I can't stop smiling.
I could tell in your email that it was almost overwhelming. And I love it when I hear stuff like this because I know that it works, but you've done your due diligence. You did all the hard work up front, and even though budget prevented you from going and buying in bulk, now you're able to buy some of the stuff in bulk, and it's exciting. I'm glad you shared it. People need to hear it. People need to know that this really can be done. What would you tell somebody just starting out?
You know what? Rob stopped by again today, and I told him I one of the big things is to look at locations before you even buy a cart. That was one thing that I actually sort of didn't do. And when I was talking to Rob today, we were kind of talking about how it can be a little awkward when you're trying to set something up with maybe a business owner somewhere, and then they ask you where your cart is, and then you tell them that you don't quite have one yet. So I guess, you know, I don't know if I just kind of lucked out a little bit by pushing off the location thing. You know what I would say? I'll just get right to the point right now. To answer your question, Ben, I would say do your due diligence, but don't spend 3 freaking years putting numbers together and trying to figure out something that you haven't even done yet. Go right out and do it. Because if I would have waited another 6 months, I probably would have never actually jumped. Something else would have came my way. You know, if a shiny object goes by, it catches my attention.
I'm the same way. Oh, my goodness, like a squirrel. yeah. Easy to get sidetracked. I understand. I appreciate you calling in and sharing. It means a lot to me that you do that. I hope you have a good evening, and if you ever want to come back in, you're more than welcome. Glad to have you.
Sounds good. Thanks, Ben.
Thank you. Caller area code 941, you are live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thanks for joining us.
941?
941.
Hey, how you doing? It's Laura from Sarasota, Florida.
Well, hi, Laura from Sarasota, Florida. How's it going?
It's going good. I'm trying to get things together, working on all of that, but there's no sound on the radio or on the TV show.
Well, the sound should be on now. Somebody told me that I had, somebody texted me and said, hey, your sound's not working, and I had it turned down too low. I could hear it, but apparently nobody else could.
Yeah, I still can't hear it. I got headphones on and everything, that's why I ended up on the phone. I can hear it through my speaker thing on my phone, but I was calling because I had problems with my commissary.
Right.
And the guy told us, he gave us this deal, you know, one-time fee because we were going to use him as our bread baker. So when we went to go get everything filled out and signed and set up for the state, he changed the pricing.
He changed the pricing and of what he was going to charge you for the bread or For the commissary usage.
For the commissary. Yeah. And all of a sudden he said, no, I never said that. And he bumped up the price by like almost $400 or $500. Now it was a yearly rate, so it was still a good pricing, but it just didn't sit well with me because I felt like...
No, he was taking advantage of you.
Exactly. So I ended up finding another place that's actually up in Sarasota. A wonderful woman who opened up a commercial bakery, and she rents out the bakery to other people, and she also signs in, lets people use it as her commissary. Wonderful place. And very, very happy with her. And I'll find out from her if it's okay with her if I share it with you then.
That is awesome. Something I hadn't considered is, you know, like Jason's on here with us, and he has a baker that he uses, but I had never considered what you just mentioned as far as finding a baker to make your buns, but also working out a commissary agreement with them. And some of them probably would give it to you free just to have you as the exclusive provider of the buns. It depends on probably how you could pitch it.
Right, exactly. And the state of Florida is very picky about who you use.
Right,
so
right.
So you can't use churches and you can't use certain places. So it really was becoming a sticky problem. So I finally got that straightened out, and then I went to do all my paperwork with the state. And I've been running into nothing but bureaucracy, which I'll get straightened out eventually, hopefully on Monday, because I've been dealing with, every time I call the state, I get a different answer for the same question.
Yeah, it's red tape. I certainly understand.
Yeah, so I'm definitely working on all of that, and I just wanted to tell you how much I appreciate your help with a lot of things.
Well, I appreciate that.
And
I appreciate that a bunch.
From there.
Well, I'm thank you for calling in, and thanks for the heads up on the audio. Hopefully it's working now.
It still isn't working for me, and I refreshed the thing like 3 times.
Oh, it's still not working?
It's still not working on either the radio or the video.
Are you kidding me? It says it's on.
The volume.
Jason, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Yeah.
But I had a hard time signing in, and then people were texting me saying there was no sound, and I said, sorry, I'm not in yet.
Wow. Well, it's working now. I mean, I'm hearing you now on the street food vendor side. The Blog Talk Radio, I don't have anything stopped there, so I don't know what would cause it. Who knows?
Sounds like it's whispering.
Yeah. Well, I thank you for letting me know. I hope you have a good evening. Thanks for calling in.
You too. Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, folks, we have a lot of people on the line tonight, but I want to, at 9:30, I'm going to do as much as I can on commissaries, and then the remainder of the hour we will spend as much getting as much questions answered as possible from callers, or if they've got a comment or story or anything. Let's see, caller area code 361, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Serious Filet.
Hello.
Mahi Mahi.
All right. Area code 361, I'll come back to you later and try you again. Area code 910, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, Ben, it's Charlie Smith with Gunny Smith's Hot Dogs in Winston Salem, North Carolina. How's it going?
All right, brother. How are you?
Pretty good. I'm excited, man. Very excited. I tell you, me and my wife were just talking. She laughed at me because I've been listening to your shows. I started listening to all your videos and training and all that kind of stuff back in September. And I know you read my email a few weeks back. I really appreciate you doing that. And, you know, we're getting ready to start with the hot dog cart. And we do our concession trailer. We sell cakes and cookies and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, I just wanted to update you on some information. I went over to Stuart Ford's house. I know he's called in, you know, quite a few times and talked with you.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Last Sunday after church, went over and he showed me his cart and showed me how he built his sneeze guard and all that kind of stuff. So I worked him, you know, because I have a big dog cart, I have to have a sneeze guard over the condiment table as well. So I got that built Thursday, and tomorrow I'll be building my sneeze guard for the table, and hopefully I'll be getting inspected this coming Thursday, and I'll be ready to set up Friday. But the reason I'm calling, I don't want to take up a lot of time. I know it's limited, but I stopped. I've been, you know, listening to your videos and stuff, but I stopped by three locations Saturday because I'm trying to get some locations locked on. Well, first place I went to was a car dealership. They didn't want to have anything to do with it. You know, they have their own thing that they do. Well, then I went by a local furniture store, which is at a very popular, well, very busy intersection right in the middle of the town. So I stopped by there, and I basically, you know, kind of used the pitch that you said. But what I did, I told the lady, I said, hey, you know, I hooked up the hot dog cart to my truck, and I drove it around. And I said, okay, I'm going to take the hot dog cart and let people see it. So I pulled up in front of their place, and I said, how you doing, ma'am? I said, my name is Charlie Smith. You know, me and my wife have a hot dog cart. I said, I'm the proud new owner of that cart right out there attached to my truck. I said, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to help local businesses increase their overall customer experience. I said, you know, I know we're just now getting started in this business, and because of that, I'm going to offer it to you at no charge. I said, I know there's vendors that actually charge for this kind of service. I said, but since we're trying to get started, we're trying to get our business name out, I want to give you that service at no charge. Her look was like, really? She had this look on her face like she was so excited, and she said, oh, well, when can you get started? I said, okay. I said, well, how does next Saturday sound? She said, well, Saturday will probably be the best day for us. You know, we just, because they have two stores. And the store used to be a Blockbuster. Half
right.
of the place is a medical, like a First Med medical center, and the other half is a mattress firm now. And she said, well, you know, we just opened, so that'll be great for our business. You know, your customers can become our customers and vice versa. I said, yeah, that's the plan. She said, okay, well, I'll tell you what, here's my business card. Call me anytime you want to set up. You know, just come on out and just let me know and blah, blah, blah. All right, sounds good to me. So,
that is perfect. You worded that perfect. I hope that people are listening. If you didn't hear it, you need to go back and listen to it. But that is perfect the way that you pitch that, because it all the results you get depends on how you pitch it. It's like we were just talking about the lady that just brought up the fact of using a, you know, her bread supplier, her bakery, as her commissary.
Right.
Can you imagine going to your baker and saying a similar thing? Say, listen, we love your bread. We would like to sell it exclusively on our cart, but we also need a commissary. And if
right.
we can work out a deal, we'll be serving your breads. In fact, if you have a vinyl sticker or something we could put on our cart, it would be good advertising for you. And we won't charge you a dime for it. We're proud to serve your bread. And so all of a sudden it sounds like you're doing something for them when ultimately you're just trying to get a commissary. And that
right.
is a brilliant move. I love what you just said.
Awesome.
Well, I
don't
I thank
take
you.
Up all the time. I know other people are trying to call in.
Well, I appreciate you, brother. I hope you have a good evening.
All right, thank you. Do the same.
You bet. All right, folks, I'm going to take one more call and before we go to the training section. And then if you're on hold waiting to talk to us, just please bear with us, and I'll try to get to you before the end of the show. Area code 301, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Hey, Ben, how you doing? Jimmy's Hot Dog Man.
Hey, Jimmy, how are you?
I'm doing better than a grasshopper in a fire pan. I'll tell you, been exciting the last couple of days. Commissaries. I'll tell you, you're doing a good thing talking about them. It can be hard to get as easy as flipping a nickel. You know, I went to the local BFW, and then for those that are veterans out there, this is a, you know, something that might be able to help them. Those that are not veterans, you can try it anyway. You know, the local BFW lets me use their facilities as a commissary absolutely free because I'm a veteran. You know, they extend that courtesy to me, so that's been my commissary for the last 3 years.
That's a good one.
And in exchange, all I do is serve free hot dogs, one on the 4th of July for their bingo crowd, and that's all I have to pay. So it's a free commissary, you know, and I go by there. And one thing I do want to pass on, if you do get a commissary, don't be a stranger. Just in case the health department happens to come by and say, I haven't seen Jimmy. And they say, no, Jimmy who, you know? Pop your head in there, you know, and let them know. Take a tour of the kitchen so you know what it's like in case you get asked a question or so. And that way you have some familiarity and they have a face they can put to it. If the health department comes to it, they say, yeah, well, yeah, do we see Jimmy all the time, you know?
Right, right.
And, you know, I mean, but the BFW, the American Legion, the disabled vets, all those facilities have kitchens they use.
Yep.
And you just go in there and let them know, hey, you know, I'm a vet, and you will never see my face, but the state requires me to have a place where I can store, clean, and, you know, prepare my food at. You know, most of them are more than happy to extend that courtesy to you.
Yep, you're right. You're right. Thank you, Jimmy. I appreciate that. That'll help out a lot of, especially vets, who may not realize that those commissaries are something that is licensed. You know, their kitchens at those places are licensed. So
exactly. Yeah, they definitely have a stringent health department criteria they have to go through to get approved. So a letter from them is like gold. And, you know, this guy fills out the letter for me every year, and it's professionally done with a letterhead on it saying, you know, he has permission to use our facility as a commissary and base operations to prepare his food. And, you know, I think people can try that as a first line of defense as far as a free one. Also, I think you mentioned before churches. They can be sticky. Try your own church first, because most of them do have a kitchen. And, you know, offer up some free food. You know, hey, they'll come out, you know, Sunday at the service or your Saturday night, you know, fellowship, and serve up some dogs for you once or twice a year or once a month. And, you know, I mean, my church just started a Saturday night vendors thing right after the 6:30, right before the 6:30 service, where they have
food
trucks come in. Now, it's not a big crowd, it's not lucrative for me to go there, but, you know, that's a place, another place I can start, where they can probably get a free commissary, you know, because I did try a restaurant, they wanted to charge me $3,000 to use their commissary.
Wow.
Or just to use their name as a commissary.
So, right. You
know, I got to jack my prices on that.
Well, Jimmy, I appreciate it, and we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back. I'm going to skip the commercial that I had planned and jump right into this, and I may even redo the introduction of the show because I had some news and stuff on there that it's important that you hear, and I want to, those on the phone already heard it, but those who were listening through Blog Talk Radio or listening through the internet didn't. They just saw my lips moving because apparently I had myself muted. I want to go into this commissary thing, and first let me cover this base. A commissary is just a fancy word for a commercial kitchen. It's a licensed kitchen. It can be used in other things too, but the gist is that most states require you have a place where you store your food, where you prep your food, and where you do your cleanup. They know that the little sinks on the cart aren't big enough. And so most states will require you have a commissary. Now, if you are listening in right now and are holding on the phone, I will get to you. I will do my best to get to everybody. But I want to get this commissary stuff out because I promised it. So we know what a commissary is. It's usually an obstacle that a lot of vendors call me and go, oh my gosh, I just found out I got to have a comma something, and I don't even know where to begin. And I have articles on the website on how to get them, but I am updating the training. And as soon as that comes out, I've got a huge section on commissaries with tips, tricks, workarounds, and all kinds of stuff. Tonight, I'm going to cover some of that, and I'm going to let you know what you can do to work around that. Here's the gist of it, though. You need a commercial restaurant, a commercial kitchen. That could be Pizza Hut, McDonald's. It could be Mom and Pop's little gas station where they serve hamburgers Monday through Friday. Odds of you getting a Pizza Hut or McDonald's are slim to none.
And Slim just left town.
Right, and Slim just left town. So it's probably not going to happen to get one of those. Even if they're privately owned franchises, they don't want the liability. But the good part is there's lots of owner-operated restaurants. And you just heard how you can approach someone about a commissary. And I have a video on how to approach them. But still, sometimes that can be overwhelming. And most vendors don't use their commissary like it's intended. They still take their pans home and clean them. They don't clean them at a commissary. Now, if you're doing a big gig and you need to prep a lot of food, that comes in handy to have a friend in the restaurant business. I had a friend that had a barbecue restaurant business, and he would let me come in anytime I wanted and chop up onions or bake. We bake these apple turnovers sometimes when we were doing side jobs, jobs where I didn't have to worry about the health department. Well, this is why a commissary is important. When you take one of those big pans home, and if you're not using pan savers or something to keep them clean during the day, you've got a lot of scrubbing to do. And it's nice to have those big deep sinks that a commissary has. Now, there's another workaround with commissaries is, and he just brought it up, Jimmy just brought it up to us, is finding places that are different, like places like daycares. Make good commissaries. You just heard from the lady from the churches. A lot of churches have licensed kitchens.
Synagogue.
Yep. Synagogue. You could go to a
Eagles Lodge, Elks Lodge,
BFW, all those places, and probably get in easier. What I would say is, hi, my name is Ben. Me and my wife make a living with a hot dog cart and a little catering company, but the state requires us to have a commissary. And if you plan on using it, I would tell them, hey, I would like to use it every now and then. I'm not going to be out every day, but I'd like to use it every now and then. But if you don't plan on using it, you can tell them, you'll probably never see me. I don't really need any food storage. We buy as we use, even if you have a deep freezer at home with 6,000 hot dogs in it. Either way, you've met the state's requirements of having a commissary. And many vendors do that. And then there's some vendors, I like having a commissary because it makes life easier. The big deep sinks, the mess, it's easier to deal with. You could do what Jason did, and he built his own commissary. And then he went a step further, and he rents out the commissary to other vendors. So you can make money with the commissary along with having a commissary that provides for you. A lot of people go, well, how do I do a commissary? Well, most states only require you have a three-bay sink, a floor drain, some of them require a mop sink, and all of them require a hand wash sink. They don't require you have a refrigerator or a stove or a hood system. They don't
have a pop sink.
They don't require you have all these appliances because you're not really using that stuff. You're unless you're cooking big vats of chili and stuff and need a hood and all that stuff, that's different. But just to meet the basic requirements of a commissary for your state, you can talk to your health inspector. It may be simple. It may be as simple as just getting a three-bay sink, which you can find on Craigslist or at a used or salvaged restaurant equipment reseller. Three-bay sink, a hand wash sink, and a floor drain is all I need here in Tennessee. That's it. I don't have to have a fridge. I don't have to have a mop bucket. I don't have to have anything else. So I can put in a portable building, which I did, just a small portable building. You know, I bought it at Lowe's for like $400. Put it up in a day. I concreted the floor. I put a floor drain over to our septic, and I put a instant on hot water heater because I didn't want to run hot water under the ground from my house over to this little building. That's all you need. That's all you have to have. In some states, that may be all you need. Another answer to this is, and I've had some vendors do this, is go into a small mom and pop restaurant and some of these places cook something unique. We talked a couple years ago about a vendor who got a commissary because the people at the little grill made cookies. So he said, listen, I'd like to sell my cookies, your cookies on my cart, but I need a commissary. And they were like, heck yeah. And they just made a deal where he gets the cookies at wholesale. He resells them on his cart, but he's got a free commissary. Now, a lot of people will say, well, how much is a commissary? Well, I know a guy that makes a living, a full-time living in the hot dog business. And he doesn't sling the first hot dog. He owns one commissary. And he's got lots of vendors that use it. If you're in an area where there's potential for more vendors, that may be an investment you want to make. Another idea, and I know I'm talking fast, but I'm trying to get through this so we can get to the calls, is there are restaurants that have closed down, stores that have closed down that have grills in them, that you may can lease, and without setting up as a business, without ever turning on you know, hanging a sign, putting up brown paper in the window so nobody can see in, and now you've got a commissary. You may find a foreclosed property like that that the bank will lease you for $300 a month. Well, it's still $300 a month, but now you've got something you can rent to other vendors and a place to store your stuff. Turn on power, turn on water, and you're good to go. Now, that can be a little more expensive route, but it works. We have a vendor that did this. He bought a, Jason, I don't remember which vendor it was, but he was on the show several times, but he bought a little mini warehouse that had a commercial kitchen in it that was in a bad part of town that was run down somewhere in Florida, and he made it into a commissary. And he started leasing out to other vendors at $300 and $400 a month to use it. Now, he had deep freezers in there and everything, and people could store their stuff. Well, that's just an idea, okay? You can try all these things. I mean, daycares, big daycares, licensed daycares, have a commercial kitchen. Most states, not Florida, but most states, and not North Carolina, have a licensed kitchen in a church. But Tennessee does. Tennessee churches have to be licensed if they have a kitchen. So they go under a different license, but it's still considered a commissary, and it's still available to use. So
we have two that just opened in Philly. Indoor, outdoor parking, huge kitchen. They have big cold room where you get like a caged cart, and all your stuff goes in the cage cart.
Right.
And people are upwards of $800,000.
Wow.
Between kitchen time, parking, dude, they'll detail your truck, they'll do your dishes, they'll load sodas, they'll grocery shop, they'll pick up your food order, have it delivered there. But, you know, you're $800,000 a month, I guess, if you're a one-man show, and, you know, you can do it. But, you know.
The goal is to not pay. I'd rather see you not pay. Or if you can figure out a way to make money with it, like Jason did. But if you can get away with not paying, Jason's business is big enough, he needs a commissary. He needs a place to store product.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? He can't be running every day to Sam's Club buying some hot dogs. So he needs hundreds and hundreds stored. He needs sausages stored and all these exotic meats he sells. And a lot of vendors do that. So a commissary is something you can do. There are some mini storage units that already have a floor drain, that already have hot and cold water. You might find that you can get a mini storage, and even if it doesn't have hot water, it may have cold water, and you can put you in a one of those on-demand heaters like we have at BenScarts.com. You can buy one of those heaters, put it in there, and now you've got hot and cold water. Put in your sinks, you've already got a drain, and you're good to go. And you need to check with your health department, your health inspector, and make sure what is required. I know some people, I know one guy that made a portable mobile commissary, and he took a trailer, not like a concession trailer, like an RV trailer, and he converted it with sinks, freezers, everything in it, got it licensed as a commercial kitchen, and then just leases that out to, or makes it available to vendors. So there's ways that you can do this. There's ways that you can profit from it, but there's also ways you can get them for free. Oftentimes the VFW, your churches, your daycares, they may go, and they may feel like, what's in it for us? But like a daycare, you could say, listen, we'd like to come by once a month and feed the kids. You know, there's little things you can do that like that, and you don't even have to offer that. You could say, hey, do y'all ever do like a outing where you take lunches? How about instead of y'all taking the lunch, I just show up with the cart and cook for everybody? Well, you just made their day, and you haven't cost them anything by using their commissary. And now you've got a place, though, if you need it, to go clean your pans, and you've got a place that makes you qualify now as a commissary. We've got about 15 minutes left, and I'm going to let it go a little bit longer, but not much, because I'm going to redo the intro. I'm going to tell you some of the info that you may have missed. I don't remember which caller we were on. I think we did area code 301, and I think the next one is 609. 609, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thanks for joining us.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
I am still alive.
Is this Brian Shores?
Yes, sir, it is.
Oh, my goodness. Flipper on the darn show. How are we doing? What are we up to? Give us an update.
His girlfriend must be out. He's loud on the phone.
Crossing the George Washington Bridge on I-95, heading for Connecticut.
Wow.
And I just, I've been sitting here listening on the phone as I've been driving, so I figured I'd call in and let y'all know I'm still alive and, you know.
Well, anything going on with your business? Have you decided if and when to get back going since your accident?
Still working on building a new cart. Started a new job. I'm back slinging cable right now instead of slinging hot dogs. So it'll be. I don't know if I'm going to make it for this summer season or not. So. Like I say, I'm just kind of playing it by ear right now.
Well, Brian, it is heck of a good to hear from you. I'm glad to hear from you. And we were asking about you the other week. Wanted to know because we hadn't heard nothing. We hadn't heard from you or Rob.
Yeah, I just, like I said, I've been feeling bad that I haven't been able to get to the shows. Like I say, just been real busy with the new job and everything like that. So. I figured I better get my butt on here and let you know I wasn't dead or anything like that.
Well, I'm glad you're alive and well. And I know that there's those that don't know, this is Brian. He has he had a hot dog business and a nice concession trailer that got wrecked. But he was set up on the beach with lots of pretty girls as customers. And so he
hates seeing his web view camera.
Yeah.
I used to tell him I hoped like nothing but fat women show up. Or I hope the seagull cracked on his camera. You know. He had these beautiful views. He'd be outside the trailer in a chair in between customers. I tried to get him to come up here and work the winter.
New York skyline has a view right now in stop and go traffic.
Oh my goodness.
All right, well, I check in. I'll let you go. Let you get into the other callers before it's still in. So.
Well, I appreciate it, brother. Thanks for calling in, Brian. It's really good to hear from you.
All right. We'll talk to you guys soon.
All righty. See you.
See you, bro.
All right, bye.
All right, folks. We've got several others on hold, and we will. I'm going to try to get to everybody. Real quick, I want to show you something. Let me pull this up.
You're not flashing again, are you?
No, not today.
Hey, I like that shirt you got on.
Yeah, isn't that sexy? Lemonade Brothers. I want to show y'all something. This is what I was showing at the beginning of the show, and if you didn't have audio, now you should have audio. But this is a website that I had custom made for vendors. It's free. The only catch is that you need to sign up through our hosting service. It's not our hosting. We're an affiliate for HostGator. If you sign up, I will upload this and provide some training videos on how to manipulate it. This is a sexy, sexy site. It has lots of features. If you want to know more about it, so I don't take up too much time, you can go over to learnhotdogs.com, click on, I think it's the second or third article down that says something about Facebook sucking lately. And did that ever pull up?
No. Oh, wait. There we go.
Okay, well, here's the site, and real quick, I'll scroll down the page. This is the site that I had created, and you can change these images. There's all kinds of cool features of this, but this is the it's a one-page site, and then it has this scrolling image in the background. We used some of Corey Lawrence's pictures for this, with his permission, of course. And anyway, if you're interested. Go to learnhotdogs.com. I think it's the second or third article down. It'll say something about Facebook in the title. That's the one you want to see. It'll give you an in-depth view of the site and the information on how to get it for free. So, we are back, and I'm going to take some calls, and let's see, where were we? 740, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thanks for calling in.
Hi, Ben. It's Jordan.
Hey, Jordan, how are you?
From Ironton, Ohio. All right. Well, we finally got to meet with the health inspector for the draw up of our plans for the court.
Oh, good.
Went a lot better than what we thought it would, even though there was the code enforcement officer there and several different other people there. I felt like a bull in a head shoot about to be denetted.
Was it nerve-wracking?
Yes, it was. Yes.
I can imagine. I know that feeling.
People, you know. I mean, it was only in about a 6 foot wide room, about 10 foot long, and you got all these people standing around, you know. I was ready to walk back out the door I come in.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
But,
especially
we got the approval.
Oh, you got it? You got it done that then?
Well, we got the plan approval because you had to draw up a plan because we were building our own cart, and you had to show them a plan before they even give you the okay to build it.
Wow.
So.
Wow. Well, I'm excited for you. So, what's your next step?
Next step is stop talking about it and put it into action. Start building the thing.
Well, good. You'll have to keep us up to date. Send in some pictures, and I'll throw them up on Facebook.
Yes, and we're pretty excited. We were excited Wednesday when we come out of there, even though it was a little nerve wracking, but. You know, there was more people. They had like the people from the Memorial Day Parade Committee member was there, and some people from the farmers market and different things that, you know, was giving you ideas where to set up, and which is something that we'd already thought about, but that made it more interesting. I mean,
well, good.
That, you know, our little town is starting to be a little concerned about where we don't have no businesses, but, you know, we got a gas station about every five or six blocks. So.
You'll do fine. You'll do fine in a little town. I posted up a letter this week on the blog, a guy that started with $700 in a little town of less than 7,500 people. And they sent in the pictures of their cart in front of this little tiny podunk gas station where he's been operating for months. And he has now made enough money. They don't speak a lick of English. And he's now made enough money to get him a restaurant, a storefront, brick and mortar. And
right.
Just impressive. I wish you well. I thank you for calling in. I'm going to run and try to get some other calls before the show ends.
Thank you for all your efforts and good hard work at helping us out that is willing and wanting to start something like this.
Well, the credit will belong all to you.
You have my full support.
Well, I thank you, brother, and please keep us up to date and call back and give us updates.
We sure will.
All righty. We'll see you. You bet. Caller area code 210, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Yeah, good evening, Ben. This is Bob in San Antonio, Texas.
Hey, Bob, how are you?
Well, real good. I thought I'd give you a real quick update, Ben. I don't want to take up a lot of time.
Oh, I'd love it.
16 months ago, I built one of your carts.
Yep.
And I'm sure you probably remember the numerous phone calls, both you and Keith. And in 16 short months, we still maintain and operate the hot dog cart. But we just purchased our first concession trailer. So it can be done. I've been on your burn hot dogs on a weekly basis, but it can be done. And that little hot dog cart made the concession trailer possible and had a lot of help from, you know, your organization. And I just want to thank you, Keith, and everybody involved. And it can be done with a do-it-yourself cart.
Well, I posted up your picture of that trailer, that sexy red dually trailer,
yes.
on Facebook. I think I just went over there to look at it, and I put 6 months, and that was a mistype of my fault, Bob. Bob did build a cart. In fact, he shared his pictures as he built. You put lights on it, if I remember correctly. And it was sexy. And built his own cart. 16 months later, he's got this sexy outfit. And he says he's going to take over the world, and Jason better watch out.
Also,
the mayor here in San Antonio is trying to revitalize the downtown area, all the parks and that, and so they've got a big push with food trucks and hot dog carts and concession trailers, and they've got five areas, different parks, downtown, in the middle of downtown, that he is really pushing, and you get into this thing, you pay $100, and then you can go into, you're assigned one of these areas, you get to pick, and then once a month they have a large gathering that everybody goes to one area, and you've got, you know, a multitude of different foods and trucks, trailers, and whatever. So
truck rodeo.
They are making a big push.
Well, that is fantastic, Bob. I appreciate you taking the time to call us. I know you're busy, and now you're fixing to be even busier, but I hope that you'll update us as you get this trailer running.
I'll do that. And again, Ben, thank you so much, because if it weren't for you guys, that trailer wouldn't be sitting out front.
Well, I thank you. I'm glad. I'm happy for you. Congratulations.
Okay, Ben, take some other calls, and now I'm going to hang on the line.
All righty. Sounds good. Caller area code 706. You're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thanks for joining us.
Hey, Ben.
Hey, is this Mr. Michael Wood from Doug's Dogs? Good, good.
Yeah, it is. I got to say something to Jason. All right, you ready, Jason? Now, that boo-boo, I sold out last week.
Did you really? You had a...
I'm serious.
Oh, that's awesome.
2 days just in a row. I mean, it was just like astronomical. People were coming up because I haven't been able to go out a lot this year because of the weather. Well, we had a severe ice storm last week, and
yeah, but wait a minute, a severe ice storm in Georgia is like two snowflakes falling.
Yeah, right. No, this was severe. I didn't have no power for 5 days, and when we finally got power, I went out, and in about 2 hours, 2 hours and 15 minutes, I sold out everything that I had in my cart, including my cooler.
Oh, my gosh.
Completely empty. Yeah. And it was like, oh, my God.
I'm glad to hear it.
Yeah, it was weird. And I felt like Jason. I'm going home at 1:30 in the afternoon, and it's like I've already sold out. So the next day I took more, and I didn't quite sell out, but I was real close.
Those are the best memories I have is when you sell out, and you get to go home early with a pocket full of money, and you know you did a good job, and people were happy.
Yeah, but see, Mike, I'm paying for it now. We're doing 120 hours a week right now, 3 months straight, and then I go back to those easy hours.
I have no desire. Well, I don't know. I worked 36 hours straight the other day.
Oh, my gosh.
At my real job. They wouldn't let me go home.
But, my gosh.
Anyway, it can be done. And so, I just wanted to, and that's at my normal spot in front of the bank. And I still had like 3 and 4 deep the whole time I was set up. And so, even in a small town, you can do it.
Oh, yeah.
Let me get off this phone. I just wanted to holler at y'all.
Well, I thank you, Michael, and congratulations. That's a good feeling.
All right. Y'all have a great day.
You too. That's Michael Wood from down in Georgia. He's got Doug's Dogs, and it's good, good. That's his slogan. Well, I've enjoyed this. I do want to tell you something else that I made an announcement, and this is thanks to Jason, actually, because he's twisted my arm to do this. Is y'all are, I'm sure you've heard of Hot Dog University, where you can go and get training. We are going to hold the first ever live training session. It will be on a limited basis. There will be a fee. You will come if you've always wanted to come to the mountains. You'll get your chance to bring your wife in. you'll get to shop and, or she'll get to shop while you learn all about hot dogs. We're not going to do it. If you've ever been over to Hot Dog University, they have a great website. They're teamed up with Vienna now. In fact, Vienna runs the program now, or owns the program. But we're not going to tour a hot dog factory. We're not going to do any of that. We're going to do the hands-on stuff that you need to know to get started, everything from the legalese to the licensing and everything, in a classroom-type setting. And then a day on a cart, we'll work and we'll make stuff and we'll do stuff different ways and we'll test stuff out, and you'll get to actually get some experience on a real cart. And if it works, I may do it again. If it doesn't work, I'll send Jason a bill. But we, if it works,
we're not going to go to the restaurant store and walk around.
No, we're not going to go to a restaurant store and walk around. I know they do that up there, but I don't see the point. I'm going to show you everything you need to know, and you'll get hands on. So if you want to know how to operate, how to do it all, we're going to do that sometime in March. I will post it up on learnhotdogs.com when it's ready.
Is this the first one in Vegas?
Yeah, I wish. It'll be in Hawaii.
St. Thomas.
and if it works, we will go sometime in the spring up to Pennsylvania and do one there with Jason on a cart and then on a concession trailer and or concession truck and kind of a whole smorgasbord with even an ice cream bike.
Yeah.
Kind of a huge training deal. So if this first one does well for us, then we'll do that. This took some talking into of my partner, Keith, who's, and holy cow. you wouldn't believe what I have to promise him.
And by that point, you might even be able to work an ice cream truck that day, too.
Yeah, there you go. So there's a lot of stuff that that you can gain from hands-on. And what we're going to try to do is do this, and if it works, we'll continue to do it. Just follow learnhotdogs.com. If you're not subscribed over there, subscribe, and you'll get an update in a newsletter that says, hey, here's the date. I have this many spots available. It's first come, first serve, period. I will have made some arrangements with a hotel so that you can get a good rate and try to get you the best rate you can go to. Obviously, you'll be able to go to any hotel you want, but if you want to use the one that's, yeah, well, there's crap loads that are close, but either way, I'll try to get you a good rate. That's really it. I've enjoyed the show. I thank everybody. I do want to ask Jason before we leave, because he had some problems getting into the show, and then he started playing his music when he came in.
That was about.
But I want to give us an update. What's going on right now?
Jamming through the weekends here, you know. We're busy as hell at the mountain. It was a great weekend, 50, 60 degrees, brought out a ton of people. The base is still real deep. Now we're going into, we got a clipper coming in tonight, and Tuesday and Wednesday we're supposed to get on 6-8 inches again, back into the freezer. We're, back down in the 30s.
Wow. So,
but it's busy as hell. I mean, it's just crazy. Absolutely crazy.
Well, I'm glad. There's a lot to be learned from your experiences and how quickly you've grown, Jason. But I'm going to welcome everybody to next week. Next week we are going to discuss buying a used cart and then take phone calls as well.
And here's something else for them to think about for next week that just came up to me. We're taking over a concession stand at a pool, at a township pool. So it's another way to think about expanding your business, looking for those type of opportunities where you're running it 6 months out of the year.
Right, right.
So, we'll have some information for that for you next week. Also, I got a hold of Jeremy from Florida. They're organizing the largest ever food truck rodeo, and we hope to have him on maybe next week or the following week to hear about that.
Oh, yeah. That'll be good.
It's a good thing about senility. You can forget about it. You meet new people every day.
Yeah. My brain's mush tonight. I tried to cram everything into this and so that we could be done, you know, at a reasonable time. I thank everybody for listening. We'll be back next week at 9 on Sunday, and we will cover used carts, and we will also, I should have the announcement by then for this date in March for the training. Remember to check out learnhotdogs.com. Look for that article that has Facebook in the title somewhere, and if you do that website thing before the end of February, you get one of my courses free, and so it tells you all the details there, so check that out. And Jason, I appreciate you coming on.
Sorry I couldn't get in.
Oh, I do want to say Yvonne from Canada,
yes,
has sent me more tips.
Yes.
I have yet to get to all of them. I've made a folder. This lady is brilliant. It's the Yvonne folder, and I'm going to hopefully.
Did you get an email from her today about what she's doing with the school program?
Yeah.
Real quick, in a nutshell, they had food trucks coming to school, and they were serving crap, and they wouldn't budge on the menu, so the school kicked them out. So she's pitching, you know, pizza day, but whole wheat crust, things like that. Good veggie toppings. I mean, she's going after some stuff this year. I'll tell you what, she is. She got some stuff on the ball. I didn't get to read the whole email because it was just nuts today. But
well, she. I'm going to try to get her to put these in a form that I can copy and paste them into the blog. And
well, why don't we get her on a show one night?
That's a good idea.
We can get a visa to allow Canuck to come in on the show. You know. She can ride a polar bear in a town and call us.
Well, just know if you're listening, Yvonne, I appreciate them. I have read them, and I've got them in a folder, and I'm going to get to them and get them on the blog.
Tell her to make sure she shoots you some pictures of her cart. You guys, her husband built a beautiful trailer for her.
Yeah. Well, folks, y'all have a good evening, and we'll be back next week. I thank you for listening, and I apologize for the audio issue again, but we'll we'll get this right eventually.
One of these times.
Vendor Radio was brought to you by BensCarts.com and the hot dog answer man himself, Mr. Ben Wilson, also by the letter H and the number 1. Tune in next week for the very best hot dog vendor information money can't buy on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio.